Hello students, welcome to third part of this periodic table chapter. So it is the part 3. So in this class I am going to explain about classification of this periodic table into blocks, classification of elements into blocks. Before going to discussion, I will explain about differentiating electron. So what is meant by differentiating electron? Differentiating electron is nothing but the last entering electron into an atom. So this is called differentiating electron. You can define like this also. So the electronic configuration of given element differs from its previous element. For example, you take electronic configuration of beryllium, atomic number 4. Its configuration is 1s2, 2s2. You take next element, electronic configuration of boron, Z is equal to 5. What is the configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. You compare these two configurations. So here 4 electrons there, here 4 electrons are there. So this is additional electron. So it is the difference between these two configurations. This electron is called differentiating electron. The electron by which the electronic configuration of given element differs from its previous element is called differentiating electron. I will take one more example. Neon, atomic number 10, electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Next element, sodium, Z is equal to 11, electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. In these two configurations, this is the difference. So hence this electron is called differentiating electron. You can see krypton, its configuration, atomic number is 36. So its configuration is 4s2, 3d10, 4p6. You take rubidium, 37, 4p6, after 4p6, 5s1 came. Up to this configuration is krypton only. So this is the additional electron. So this electron is called differentiating electron. In boron case, differentiating electron enters into P subshell. So that's why boron is called P block element. You take sodium, differentiating electron enters into S subshell, hence sodium is a S block element. Rubidium, differentiating electron enters into S subshell, so rubidium is S block. Krypton, differentiating electron enters into P, so it is a P block element. Krypton is a P block element. So the entire periodic table, the elements in the periodic table are classified into four blocks. The elements in the periodic table are classified into four blocks, that are 1 S block elements, 2 P block elements, 3 D block elements, 4 F block elements. So entire periodic table is divided into four blocks, classified into four blocks: S block elements, P block, D block and F block elements. We will see one by one. So it is the periodic table. So this part, is S block, S block elements. This part is P block. This middle part, main body, this is D block, and the last one is F block. So S block elements are present on left side, P block elements are present on right side. It is P block, it is S block. Main body is D block, bottom of the periodic table is F block elements. So it is the S block, left side, P block elements, right side, D block element in between S and P, where F block is located under the main body of the periodic table, at the bottom of the periodic table, S block elements. That means entire table is classified into four blocks: S block, P block, D block and F block. So what are S block elements? How to define S block elements? The elements in which differentiating electron enters into S subshell are called S block elements. So you can take here hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. In all these elements, differentiating electron enters into S subshell. For example, electronic configuration of hydrogen is 1s1, S subshell. Lithium, 1s2, 2s1, S1. For all these elements, last electron configuration is S1. For all these elements, S2. So the elements in which differentiating electron enters into S subshell are called S block elements. You know already, they are placed at left side of the periodic table. S block elements are placed at left side of the periodic table. S subshell can accommodate only two electrons. It is the S subshell, it can accommodate only two electrons. Hence, there are only two groups in S block, that is, one is group 1, this is group 1 and this is group 2. So in S block, how many groups are there? Only two groups. Why only two groups? Because S subshell can accommodate only two electrons. S subshell can accommodate only two electrons. Hence, there are only two groups. Group 1 elements are called alkali metals. Group 2 elements are called alkaline earth metals. Group 2 elements are called alkaline earth metals. So, S subshell can accommodate only two electrons. Hence, there are only two groups in S block. They are group 1 and group 2. From S block, so except this hydrogen, except hydrogen. All S block elements are reactive metals. All S block elements are more electropositive or more reactive metals. So this is about S block elements. What is the general electronic configuration of S block elements? For group 1, NS1, for group 2, NS2. So hence, total S block elements general configuration is NS122. For group elements, for group 1 elements, NS1. For group 2 elements, NS2. So general configuration is NS122. You can see here lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. So configuration 1s1, 2s1, 3s1, 4s1, 5s1, 6s1, 7s1. So these group 1 elements are called alkali metals. General configuration of alkali metals, group 1 elements NS1. Group 2 elements NS2. For S block elements, general configuration of S block elements is NS122. This is important. General electronic configuration of S block elements. S block elements. So alkali metals NS1, alkaline earth metals NS2. So it is the position of S block in the periodic table. S block. So what are S block elements? The elements in which differentiating electron enters into S subshell. They are present on left side of the periodic table. There are only two groups because S subshell contains only two electrons. General configuration is NS122. Next one is P block. In the same way, you have to define the elements in which differentiating electron enters into P subshell are called P block elements. It is the definition. What are P block elements? What are P block elements? The elements in which differentiating electron enters into P subshell are called P block elements. They are placed at the right side of the periodic table. You know it is S block. This right side is P block. This middle part is D block. This bottom part is F block. They are placed at right side of the periodic table. You know P subshell contains, it is entire P subshell. It contains three orbitals, each orbital 2 electrons, 2, 2, 2, total electrons 6. P subshell can accommodate only 6 electrons. So there are 6 groups in P block. There are 6 groups in P block. They are group 13 to group 18. That means group 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. How many groups are there? 6 groups are there. P block includes metals, non-metals and metalloids. It includes all types. Whereas in S block, only metals. In P block, 3 types of elements. Metals, non-metals and metalloids. Once again, what are P block elements? The elements in which differentiating electron enters into P subshell are called P block elements. They are placed at right side of the periodic table. P subshell can accommodate only 6 electrons. So there are 6 groups in P block. They are from group 13 to group 18. P block includes metals, non-metals and metalloids. You can see here it is the P block. Group 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. In old system, 3rd A, 4th A, 5th A, 6th A, 7th A, and 0 group. 3rd A, 4A, 5A, 6A, 7th A, and 0. So in IUPAC system, group 13 to 18. So these are metalloids, non-metals, some metals also there, metals. So it includes all types of elements. So you will see this is group 13 elements: boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. So these are the elements of group 13. So group 14 elements: carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, lead. Group 15 elements: nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth. Group 16 elements: oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium. Group 17 elements: fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. Group 18 elements: 17, 16, 15, group 18 elements. It is neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. So total 6 groups. What is the configuration of group 13 elements? Group 13 elements configuration is only for group 13. NS2, NP1. It is P1 for all these 5 elements. P1, for example, boron 3s2s2 2p1, aluminium 3s2 3p1 p1. So group 14 elements, in the same way it ends with p2. So general configuration of group 14 elements is ns2 np2. Group 15 elements NS2 NP3. Group 16 elements NS2 NP4. Group 17 elements NS2 NP5. Group 18 elements NS2 NP6. So you combine these 6 groups configuration, you will get NS2 NP 1 to 6. It is the general configuration of p block elements. General outer electronic configuration of p block elements is ns2 np 1 to 6. Now what are p block elements? The elements in which differentiating electron enters into p subshell are called p block elements. They are placed at the right side of the periodic table. P subshell can accommodate 6 electrons, hence there are 6 groups. They contain metals, non-metals and metalloids. Their general configuration is NS2, NP1 to 6. So next type D-block elements. D-block elements. So before that, you see in an atom, this is nucleus, these are cells. So K, L, M, N are first orbit, second orbit, third, fourth. It is called this last one, N, nth cell. This is called N minus 1 and this is called N minus 2. So nth cell, that means last cell, nth cell, you can call it as valency cell or outermost cell. Or ultimate अल्टीमेट सेल, अल्टीमेट सेल, दिस एन माइनस वन लास्ट बट वन इज कॉल्ड पेनल्टीमेट सेल. लास्ट बट वन इज कॉल्ड एन माइनस वन इज कॉल्ड पेनल्टीमेट. एन माइनस टू इज कॉल्ड एंटी पेनल्टीमेट सेल. एन माइनस टू इज कॉल्ड एंटी पेनल्टीमेट सेल. वाई आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट पेनल्टीमेट एंटी पेनल्टीमेट मीन्स इन एस ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स डिफरेंशिएटिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन एंटर्स इनटू एस सबसेल ऑफ वैलेंस सेल. इन पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट डिफरेंशिएटिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन एंटर्स इनटू पी सबसेल ऑफ वैलेंस सेल. बट इन डी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स डिफरेंशिएटिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन एंटर्स इनटू डी सबसेल ऑफ एन माइनस वन. Means this is n minus 1 here. Differentiating will electron will enter into d subcell of penultimate cell. So these elements are called d block elements. What are d block elements? What are d block elements? The elements in which differentiating electron enters into n minus 1d, n minus 1d subshell, that means subshell, d subshell present in penultimate cell. This n minus 1d is called penultimate. So the elements in which differentiating electron enters into d subshell of n minus 1 are called d block elements. They are placed in between s and p blocks. You know d subshell contains 5 orbitals, each orbital 2 electrons, so maximum number of electrons are 10. D subshell can accommodate 10 electrons, so there are 10 groups in d block. They are from group 3 to 12. How many groups? 10 groups. So from group 3 to group 12, d block elements are also known as transition metals other than this group 12. So that means group 3 to group 11, these elements are also known as transition metals. Transition metals. What are d block metals? The elements in which differentiating electron enters into n minus 1d subshell are called d block elements. They are placed in between s and p blocks. D block contains 10 groups. D block elements are also known as transition metals. You see, the d orbitals fill up in level 1 less than the period number. It is first period, second period, third period, fourth period. This is fourth period. In fourth period, 3d orbital is filling. So it is scandium, scandium to zinc, scandium, titanium, vanadium, chromium, manganese, iron, cobalt, nickel, copper, zinc. So these elements, in these elements 3d orbital is progressively filled. 3d orbital, but here valence shell is fourth shell. Here n is equal to 4, n minus 1 is equal to 3. So n minus 1d, that means 3d. So 3d series is present in fourth period. Next one, next series, this is called 4d series. This is called 5d series. This is called 6d series. D block elements contains 10 groups. At the same time, D block we will study in terms of series, 4 series of elements. They are 3D, 4D, 5D, 6D. 3D series elements are present in 4th period. 4D series elements are present in 5th period. Here D block element is always less than, 1 less than the D orbitals fill up in levels 1 less than the period number. So the first D is 3D even though it is row 4. 3D series is present in 4th period. So you have to remember n minus 1D. Now 6D series is present in which period? Yes, 7th period. 4D, 5D, 6D. So these are the series. How many D block elements are classified into 4 series of elements? In terms of series, D block elements are classified into how many groups? 10 groups. Group 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. In D block, these elements have similar properties. The elements in a group have similar properties already you know. But in D block, this 3D series also have some similar properties. 3D series, total number of elements are 10. From scandium to zinc, 10 elements. 4D series, from yttrium to cadmium, 10 elements. 5D series, lutetium to mercury, 10 elements. 6D series, this is a lanthanum, sorry, it is lanthanum, it is actinium, actinium. So here 10 elements, so it is some other elements also there, new elements. So total some books, they will give 6D series is incomplete series. Here copernicium, so total 10 elements given 6D series. Now point is, what is the configuration of scandium? 4s2 3D1. Next titanium 4s2 3D2. Vanadium 4s2 3D3. You know chromium configuration and copper configuration are anomalous. Difference is there. 4s1 3D5. Manganese 4s2 3D5. Iron 4s2 3D6. Cobalt 4s2 3D7, nickel 4s2 3D8, copper again anomalous configuration 4s1 3D10, zinc 4s2 3D10. How to write for these 10 elements? 4s, 2 is there, for 2 elements 1 also there, 4s1 to 3D starting 1 to 10, 4s 1 to 2, 3D 1 to 10. So you can write NS 1 to 2, N minus 1 D 1 to 10. It is the general configuration of. So D block contains 4 series, 4 transition series. So this 3D series, you can call it as first transition series. Already I told D block elements are also known as transition metals. Hence 3D series is called first transition series, 4D series is called second transition series, 5D series is called third transition series, 6D series is called fourth transition series. So 3D series starting element is scandium atomic number 21 to zinc atomic number 30. Yttrium to cadmium, like this. D block contains how many series of elements? 4 series of elements. You see the configuration of scandium, 3D1. Yttrium, 4D1. Lanthanum, 5D1. Actinium, 6D1. So like this, for all these elements, D2. For all these elements, D3. For all these elements, D5, एन एस वन एन माइनस वन डी फाइव, एन माइनस वन डी टेन फॉर दिस कॉपर सिल्वर गोल्ड जिंक कैडमियम मर्क्यूरी. सो फॉर ओनली फॉर थ्री डी, ओनली फॉर थ्री डी यू नो हाउ टू राइट थ्री डी वन टू टेन फोर एस वन टू टू, इट इज फॉर थ्री डी. ओनली फॉर फोर डी सीरीज फोर डी वन टू टेन फाइव एस वन टू टू. So total for D block, you can write this is the configuration. General electronic configuration of D block elements, it is very very important. General electronic configuration of D block elements or transition elements for both. General electronic configuration of D block elements or transition metals is n minus 1 D 1 to 10 NS 1 to 2. NS 1 to 2. So you can see here some variation. Note the changes in the configuration of this copper, silver, gold. Here configuration is different. Anomalous. Here chromium. Chromium, molybdenum and tungsten. So it is about D block. Now you will see F block elements. F block elements. The elements in which differentiating electron enters into, the elements in which differentiating electron enters into n minus 2 f subcell, n minus 2 f subcell are called f block elements. Already I told n minus 2 f subcell is called anti penultimate cell, anti penultimate cell. What are f block elements? The elements in which differentiating electron enters into n minus 2 f subcell are called f block elements. They are placed under the main body of the periodic table. They are placed at the bottom of the periodic table. F block contains two series of elements. They are 4f and 5f. 4F and 5F. 4F series elements are called lanthanides. Very very important. So there are 14 elements. Cerium to lutetium. Element cerium to lutetium. 58 atomic number to 71. The elements from cerium to lutetium, that 14 elements, these 14 elements are called lanthanides. If they asked what are lanthanides, you have to write 4F series elements are called lanthanides. Similarly, 5F series elements are called actinides. These are thorium to lawrencium, atomic number 90 to 103. These are also 14 elements. 5F series elements. These 14 elements from thorium to lawrencium are called actinides. Both lanthanides and actinides are included in F block. So this is the F block. It is present under main body of the periodic table. F block elements are also known as inner transition elements. Whereas D block elements are called transition elements. D block transition elements, F block inner transition elements. These are 4F series, these are 5F series. Cerium to lutetium, thorium to lawrencium 14 plus 14. So these elements are called F block elements. So there are two rows, two series of elements at the bottom of the periodic table: lanthanides, cerium to lutetium, actinides, thorium to lawrencium. This is important. Configuration of F block elements. n minus 2, n minus 2, n minus 2, f 1 to 14, n minus 2, f 1 to 14, n minus 1, d 0 to 1, ns 2. So, this is the general configuration for a block elements as well as inner transition elements. N minus 2, f 1 to 14, n minus 1, d 0 to 1, ns 2. So, these are called a block elements. It is the configuration. Lanthanides have some name. Lanthanide elements are also called rare earths, because they are rarely found in earth crust. Rare earth. Lanthanides are called rare earths. So, the elements from 90 to 103. So, 92 also included here only. That 92 is uranium. So, 92 to others. So, these elements are called transuranic elements. The elements came after uranium. The elements came after uranium, after atomic number 92 are called transuranic elements. All these elements are artificial elements. All these elements are artificial elements or man-made elements. Man-made are radioactive elements. Radioactive elements. Actinides are radioactive elements, artificial elements, man-made elements. What are transuranic elements? Elements with atomic number greater than 92. 92 onwards are called transuranic elements. In f orbitals, starting f, 4f, are 2 less than the period number. That means 4f series is found in 6th period, because it is n minus 2f, where n is period number. 5f series is found in, 5f series is included in 7th period. 4f series is included in 6th period. 5f series is included in 7th period. Now, question is, what is the position of lanthanides in the periodic table? Lanthanides belongs to F block. Lanthanides belongs to 6th period. Lanthanides belongs to this group only. What is the group number here? Group 3. In groups, scandium, yttrium, lanthanum, actinum. Lanthanum plus this 14 also. Actinium plus this 14 also. So, how many elements are there in group 3? Group 3, 4 plus visible elements, scandium, yttrium, lanthanum, actinum, plus 14. In group 3, how many elements are there? 4 plus 14 lanthanides plus 14 actinides. Total 32 elements are there. So, now one more question. What is the position of actinides in the periodic table? Actinides in the periodic table. What is the position? Actinides belongs to F block. Actinides belongs to 7th period. Actinides belongs to 3rd group. 3rd group. So, this is about classification of elements into SPDF blocks. In the next class, I will explain classification of elements based on chemical properties. Like blocks, one more classification is there. Elements in the periodic table are classified into types, 4 types. That was I will explain in next class. Okay, thank you.